हाय हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टेस्ट, विच टेस्ट यू विल बी डूइंग जनरली फॉर द डिस्टिंग्विशमेंट ऑफ अल्कोहल्स, प्राइमरी सेकेंडरी टर्शियरी अल्कोहल्स। ओके, सो फॉर दिस आई वुड लाइक टू ब्रिंग इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट लो कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इन दिस क्लास एज वेल एज विक्टर मेयर टेस्ट and some added information if needed at the time of examination cases and all. Okay, thank you. Let us move on to the class. See, the test is called Lukacs test. Usually in this test what will happen, there is a mixture of concentrated HCl. This is mixture of concentrated HCl and anhydrous ZnCl2. It is anhydrous ZnCl2 will take. This mixture is called as Lukacs reagent. This is nothing but the reagent we will use. And if this Lukacs reagent is reacts with alcohol, it forms the corresponding alkyl halides. Okay, and which is insoluble. Suppose if the Lukacs reagent is treated with alcohol, what is the actual thing happens is nothing but it forms alkyl chlorides. Alkyl chlorides, you know, in this chloride is there, and this presence of alkyl chloride in this reaction shows they are giving white precipitate or cloudiness. This is because of insolubility in the reagent. That means alkyl chlorides are insoluble in this Lukacs reagent. Insoluble because of that one, they forms cloudiness. We can say they forms cloudiness, and that is also called as a turbidity. We can also call that is turbidity, or you can say it is a PPT. So this mixed concentration HCl and hydrogen Cl2 with alcohols, primary and secondary alcohols, will give this alkyl chloride. This alkyl chloride is insoluble, and the insolubility is nothing but formation of cloudiness or turbidity or PPT in the reaction. Because of this, we can say this cloudiness appears when the chloride separates from the solution, and hence the time required for cloudiness to appear is a measure of reactivity of alcohol. For example, so cloudiness appears. When it appears? After particular time intervals. For example, cloudiness appears immediately. Appears immediately. If the cloudiness appears immediately, then we can call that is a tertiary alcohol. The tertiary alcohol. If the cloudiness appears in 5 minutes. In 5 minutes, then that is called as secondary alcohol. That is called as secondary alcohol. Suppose there is no such thing happen, that means there is no color appears, so solution remains colorless. Remains colorless means that is called as primary alcohol. So there is no time and there is no cloudiness, then that is called as primary alcohol. Primary alcohol. So no appearance of cloudiness. So here we can understand that tertiary alcohols are said to give immediately, and primary alcohols are not giving this test. So secondary and tertiary alcohols can give within a particular time interval. The tertiary alcohol reacts definitely immediately with 3 azofast agent. Secondary alcohol reacts with 5 minutes, and primary alcohol does not react appreciably at normal temperature. That means this is also happens at room temperature only. So if you heat it extensively, then there is a possibility of getting fragility in the primary alcohol. But at room temperature only, we will do this test that appears clear solution, that is called as primary alcohol. Friends, now we will see how this primary alcohols or secondary tertiary alcohols reacts with low-cost agent with a general reaction mechanism. Okay, so as you all know that alcohols are nothing but ROH. Their general formula is ROH. I am writing ROH like this. And over the oxygen, everybody knows that there are two pairs of electrons are present. And if this oxygen is attacking with the zinc chloride in the low pass reagent, then zinc chloride forms a coxonium ion with this alcohol. So oxygen will become positive charge here, and only one pair of electron is there with the three bonds, and a third bond with the ZnCl2 will be formed. And in this case, zinc will become negative in the reaction. So this is our step one. That means this is our step one. We got oxonium ion, and in this step one, we identified that zinc is forming a oxonium complex with the alcohol. Coming to the second step. In the second step, what will happen? As you all know, that hydrogen chloride we are adding. That in this chlorine is negative, so around that there are three pairs of electrons are present around the chlorine. And if this chlorine is again reacting with this oxonium ion, now chlorine starts reacting with oxonium ion obtained in the step one, where zinc is negative, oxygen is positive with a pair of electrons. So here what will happen is nothing but this chloride attacks on this alkyl group. Chloride wants alkyl group. At the same time, the bond between this alkyl group and this oxygen will move towards oxygen, more electronegative, and it takes easily. This oxygen's positive charge will get neutralized in the reaction. At the same time, this OH whatever is there with zinc and Cl2 forms a zinc complex type of compound. And immediately after the formation of this alkyl chloride, so alkyl chloride is RCl, which is formed, and with zinc, the rest of the species will form zinc hydroxochloride, ZnOH twice, ZnOH Cl2 will be formed. Usually, zinc forms tetrahydroxy compounds. That means tetrahydride compounds, metal compounds. In that, this zinc compound is not stable. Whatever obtained, which in turn immediately converts into the zinc chloride, which is taken initially, and which absorbs the water separately. So we will write water separately in the reaction. So friends, this is a step two in this reaction of low-cost reagent with respect to alcohols primary, secondary and tertiary. So friends, we observed low-cost reagent how reacts with particular alcohols primary, secondary, tertiary, in which immediately if the turbidity obtained, then what is the alcohol, type of alcohol? Type of alcohol is nothing but tertiary alcohol. If we got the turbidity or cloudiness after 5 minutes, then that is called as secondary alcohol. But this all takes place at room temperature only. Suppose in the case of this primary alcohols, if you heat at high temperatures, there is a possibility of getting cloudiness after 10 minutes. So this is also one of the most important observation for the distinguishing of primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols in the determination of alcohols, and how to identify particular alcohol is easy with this test. Okay, thank you. Now we will see the second important test for the distinguishment of alcohols is called as Richter-Mayer test. Richter-Mayer test. So according to this one, you can say this test is one of the most important method, you can say, for the identification of alcohols, primary, secondary, tertiary alcohols. And also in this method, we can say primary, secondary, tertiary alcohols are said to be subjected to a series of chemical reactions. Actually, a series of chemical reactions will take place in this Richter-Mayer test, and the analysis will give color to a particular alcohol. So different steps involved in this one we will see. The first we will do one thing in this Richter-Mayer test. The first test is nothing but the alcohol will be treated with iodine. So first we will take alcohol, and that will be treated with iodine. The iodine must be red phosphorus in iodine. Red phosphorus with iodine, or if it is not there, means directly you can say it is alcohol reacting with iodide. So as you know, iodide gives alkyl iodide in this step. So first step, when this reaction takes place, means what will be formed, means iodide will be formed, iodo alkane will be formed. So iodo alkane is the first step of the Richter-Mayer test. Coming to the second one, so second one, what will happen, we will again take this iodo alkane in this step. The iodo alkane will be treated with silver nitrate, alcoholic silver nitrite. It is not nitrate, it is nitrite. So in order to obtain a nitro alkane, so after that we will get a compound called as nitro alkane. And coming to the third step, in the third step, whatever nitro alkane is there, the nitro alkane is treated with the nitrous acid. So nitro alkane, whatever we obtained in the second step, the nitro alkane will be treated with nitrous acid. This is nothing but a nitrous acid. So that nitric acid can be obtained by treating sodium nitrite with HCl. As you know, in the digestion test also we did the same thing. Okay, this will be obtained. So once this mixture reacts, it will give a compound which is called as the nitrolic acid. The compound obtained in the step is called as nitrolic acid. Nitrolic acid. And coming to the fourth step, what we will do, once the nitrolic acid or nitrogen compound obtained, or any kind of compound called as nitrole obtained, then that will be treated with excess of this sodium hydroxide or caustic soda. So if you treat that one with caustic soda, then in the fourth step we will get different colors. For example, if we got a red color in the fourth step, so you can say blood red color obtained, then that is called as primary alcohol. Suppose we got blue color, that means blue color is nothing but the blue color which is obtained in this step, then that we will call it as secondary alcohol. In if suppose there is no color obtained, that means it remains colorless, the compound, remains colorless or no color. We can say no color, or sometimes we can call it as white also. So if it is white case, then that alcohol we will call it as tertiary alcohol in the Vectormeyer test. See, in the Vectormeyer test, the first step is nothing but alcohol will be treated with red phosphorus iodine or iodide, hydrogen iodide will give iodoalkane. The second step is nothing but this iodoalkane treated with silver nitrite gives nitroalkanes. After that, this nitroalkanes will be treated with nitrous acid. NaNO2 plus HCl will give this nitrous acid, this HCl, and we may get nitrolic acid or nitrol or any kind of salt of that compound. So the salt may be nitrolic acid or nitrol, pseudonitrol, that will be further treated with excess of sodium hydroxide caustic soda, gives red color, blue color, white color. So in that way we can identify primary, secondary, tertiary alcohols in the fourth step. The reason why we will call this reaction is RBW test. This test is also called as RBW test. So what is the another name for Vectormeyer test is nothing but RBW. So R is nothing but red and B is nothing but blue and W is nothing but white. That's why this is the another name is RBW test. Now we will see how that particular alcohol, for example, if I take ethyl alcohol, gives this series of reactions, how it gives a series of reactions like the secondary alcohol and tertiary alcohol also, I'll show it to you. So first I would like to take ethyl alcohol. So as you know, ethyl alcohol is nothing but CH3 CH2OH. So if this ethyl alcohol is taken with iodine or phosphorus in iodine, then this ethyl alcohol will be converted into iodide as said earlier. So this is the CH3CH2I will come in this step. So the next, what is our second step? The second step is nothing but the treating this one with silver nitrate. So silver nitrite is nothing but AgNO2, silver nitrite it is. So it gives a compound that is nitroalkane. So see, so when it reacts with silver nitrate, in that case we will get a nitro compound that is CH3 CH2 NO2. So nitro compound we obtained. So further we treat that one with nitric acid, nitrous acid obtained from NaNO2 and HCl, then what will happen, it gives a compound nitrolic acid. The compound formed in this step is called as nitrolic acid, that is CH3C double bond O NOH, NO2 here, NOH will be present here. Just a minute. So this can be written like this, NOH. So in this step, once we treat this salt of, this is called as nitrolic acid, this will be treated with sodium hydroxide or alkali, then we will get that red coloration. So red coloration will come after this treatment with sodium hydroxide. This is the series of reactions for ethyl alcohol. Now let us see secondary alcohol how gives this Vectormeyer test. Secondary alcohol, if you take treated with phosphorus and iodine, and you will get iodide, will be treated with silver nitrite, get nitroalkane, and further treated with nitrous acid, you get pseudonitrol. So this is pseudonitrol. If you treat this one with sodium hydroxide, you will get salt of the pseudonitrol, that is called as blue color. In that way you can identify secondary alcohol. See, in the case of tertiary alcohol, isobutyl alcohol I have taken. So in the tertiary alcohol case, what will happen? This iodine gives iodide, and after the silver nitrate gives nitro compound, nitroalkane. But after treating with nitrous acid, there is no reaction takes place, because of that one the solution remains colorless, indicates that this is tertiary alcohol. So victremy test gives primary test, primary alcohol gives red color test, and secondary alcohol in the victremy test will give blue color test, blue color, and tertiary alcohol won't give any kind of color. That's why we call this is RBW test. So friends, we understand what is Lucas test and what is Victremere test. So this Victremere test is most important, as well as Lucas test also. Both the tests in the competitive examinations and theory examinations, several times they have asked. So hope you understand what I discussed in the identification methods of alcohol food tests. Please prepare these two tests as clear as possible, because this test will give definitely one question in the competitive examinations. Okay, hope you understand this class. And coming to the next session, I'll be bringing about the phenols concepts. Okay, up to that, thank you very much.